Dear students, today we are going to start lesson 4, Materials, Metals and Nonmetals. Topic to be covered in this lesson are introduction of lesson. Firstly, you will understood what is the meaning of this lesson. Then after metals, physical properties of metals, nonmetals, physical properties of nonmetals, chemical properties of metals and nonmetals, reaction with oxygen, reaction with water, reaction with acids, reaction with bases, displacement reaction. Finally, we will study about usage of metals and nonmetals. Let's come to know about materials or thing. Anything which occupies a space and has mass is called matter or thing. We see a large number of materials or things around us, like chair, eraser, bucket, and so on. From these, some are metallic and non-metallic, and some are metalloids. After that, we will study about one by one metallic, non-metallic, and metalloids. First of all, we are going to study about history of metals. First, metals which discovered was gold. About 6000 BC means long back from present. Gradually, as time passed, other metals were also discovered. You can see it in this, I'm just explaining this one. Gold 6000 BC, copper 4200 BC. These are the discovered time of the metals. After that, silver 4000 BC, lead 3500 BC, and so on. At last, this variety of ways means this is continue. Discovery is not finished. It is continue. Aluminium is in 1827. Variety of ways in which aluminiums are used in these days are vessels, aluminium foil, wire, and so on. Metals actually took a very long time to discover it. It started in 6000 BC and continued till now. Discovery keeps going on means it will never be stopped. Okay, let's see here in this page number. You will see anything which occupies a space and has mass is called matter. Example, chair, eraser, bucket, and so on. Element is substance which cannot be split up into two or more simpler substances by usual chemical methods. Iron, oxygen, magnesium, these all are the examples of the elements. Okay. Elements can be classified into metals, nonmetals, and metalloids depending upon their physical and chemical properties. Elements, we can classify to the elements on the physical and chemical properties of particular elements. Metals, elements can be metals, elements can be non-metals, and elements can be metalloids. One by one, iron, copper, tin, gold, these all are the examples of metals. Because it has, they all have the hard shape and shiny structure and shiny in appearance, non-metals. Sulfur, poisonous, phosphorus, sulfur, phosphorus, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, these all are the examples of non-metals. Generally, they are not so hard, means non-metals are not hard in nature and metals are hard in nature. Most of them, means non-metals, have dull appearance. It has no shining, so it is dull appearance. Metalloids means the elements which have no quality of the metals and the non-metals called metalloids. Examples are there, arsenic, antimony, and germanium are some examples of metalloids. These all have the no quality, means characteristics of the metals and non-metals. Occurrence of metals and non-metals means those minerals in the earth crust, lots of the minerals are occur. So those minerals from which the metals can be extracted conveniently and profitably are called ores. From ores, we are getting the metals. These ores occurs in the crust of the earth.
ओके, इन द ओर्स सर्टेन इम्प्योरिटीज आर प्रेजेंट अलोंग विद मेटलिक मिनरल्स. दीज इम्प्योरिटीज आर कॉल्ड गैंग. अर्थ क्रस्ट मेटल्स आर फाउंड इन देयर कंबाइंड स्टेट्स इन फ्री स्टेट्स ऑल्सो. अकरेंस ऑफ सम नॉन मेटल्स आर नाइट्रोजन, हाइड्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन, कार्बन, सल्फर. आफ्टर दैट ओके, द सीरीज ऑफ प्रोसेस कैरीड आउट टू एक्सट्रैक्ट प्योर मेटल्स फ्रॉम दियर ओर्स इज कॉल्ड द मेटलर्जी. मीन्स प्रोसेस बाई विच द फ्रॉम द ओर्स मेटल्स आर एक्सट्रैक्टेड. दिस प्रोसेस आर नोन एज द मेटलर्जी. बॉक्साइट, दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ द ओर्स. आयरन पायराइट्स, हेमेटाइट्स एंड कॉपर ग्लैंसेस. ओके, फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज मीन्स एग्जिस्टेंस. बाय फ्रॉम अपर साइड वी कैन ऑब्जर्व दीज आर द मेटल्स एंड दीज आर द नॉन मेटल्स. सो दीज आर द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज. फिजिकल स्टेट, मोस्ट ऑफ द मेटल्स आर सॉलिड एट रूम टेम्परेचर. मर्करी, सम एक्सेप्शंस आर इन द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द मेटल्स. मर्करी इज ओनली मेटल नोन टू अकर इन लिक्विड स्टेट इन नेचर एट रूम टेम्परेचर. नो मेटल एग्जिस्ट इन गैसियस स्टेट. मीन्स ऑल द मेटल्स आर अकर इन सॉलिड स्टेट. नो एनी मेटल्स अकर इन द गैसियस स्टेट. हाइड्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन, दीज आर टाइप्स ऑफ द गैसेस. मेटल्स आर नॉट द कम्स इन नेचर इन द गैसेस स्टेट. वन मेटल इन द एक्सेप्शन मर्करी, इट इज अ फॉर यू ऑल आर सीइंग इन द थर्मामीटर टेम्परेचर मेजर थर्मामीटर यू आर सीइंग मर्करी. इट इज फाउंड, इट इज अकर इन द रूम टेम्परेचर लिक्विड स्टेट. नॉन मेटल्स आर जनरली सॉलिड और गैसेस. नॉन मेटल्स लाइक सल्फर, फॉस्फोरस एंड कार्बन आर सॉलिड्स. नॉन मेटल्स लाइक हाइड्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन एंड नाइट्रोजन आर गैसेस. ब्रोमाइन इज ओनली नॉन मेटल्स विच एग्जिस्ट एज लिक्विड एट रूम टेम्परेचर. इन द केस ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स ऑल्सो ब्रोमाइन इज ओनली नॉन मेटल्स विच एग्जिस्ट एज लिक्विड एट रूम टेम्परेचर. नॉन मेटल्स ऑल्सो फाउंड इन नेचर इन द सॉलिड स्टेट एंड गैसेस स्टेट बट इट इज अकर इन लिक्विड स्टेट ब्रोमाइन. मैलेबिलिटी एंड ब्रिटलनेस, दिस इज द सेकेंड फिजिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द मेटल्स. मैलेबिलिटी एंड ब्रिटलनेस मीन्स यू आर सीइंग इन योर होम एल्युमिनियम फॉइल. दीज आर द फॉर्म्स ऑफ द मैलेबिलिटी, एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द मैलेबिलिटी. एल्युमिनियम्स, वेन वी हिट टू द एल्युमिनियम्स, वी मीन्स द पीपल्स दोज हु आर मैन्युफैक्चर टू द एल्युमिनियम फॉइल. वेन वी हिट टू द एल्युमिनियम्स देन इट विल चेंज, इट कन्वर्ट इन अ थिन सीड्स, दैट इज नोन एज द एल्युमिनियम फॉइल. द प्रॉपर्टी विच अलाउ द मेटल्स टू बी हैमर्ड इन टू थिन सीड्स और फॉइल्स इज कॉल्ड द मैलेबिलिटी. गोल्ड, सिल्वर, एल्युमिनियम एंड कॉपर आर हाईली मैलिएबल मेटल्स. मैनी ऑफ द मेटल्स आर देयर बट दीज ऑल आर द हाईली मैलिएबल मेटल्स. इट मीन्स इट कैन स्प्रेड इन द थिन टू थिन सीड्स एंड कंपेरेबल टू द अदर मेटल्स. बिकॉज ऑफ दीज प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मेटल्स दे आर वेरी यूजफुल टू अस. ओके, नाउ द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ property due to which non-metals break up into pieces on hammering is called the brittleness. Non-metals, when we hit to the non-metals, it cannot be spread into the seeds. It can hammer, after the hammering, it will brittle, means break down into the pieces. So, non-metals are generally brittle. For example, sulfur and coal break up into small pieces on hammering, means when you give the hit, it means hammering. In the activity 1, you are seeing here to show that metals are malleable and non-metals are brittle. Some pieces for this you will take a thing, some pieces of aluminium, this is the examples of the metals. Copper, iron, coal is the non-metals. Copper, iron means metals. Pencil is also the non-metals, lead, sulfur. These all metals and non-metals you will take and combine form, and after that take a piece of aluminium metals, place it on a block of iron, beat it with a hammer. means I'll first you have to take a aluminium metal and place it on a block of iron and beat it with a hammer. You will give the heat to that, beat it. Similarly, hammer and other given substances and observe. Okay, now observation. You find that the piece of aluminium metal turns into a thin aluminium sheets without breaking at all. Means it is a metals. Without breaking it, it will spread into the thin sheets because it is a metal. Similarly, you observe that copper and iron get flattened due to the hammer and turn into thin sheets because breaking. Without breaking. And point number third, however, the coal is a non-metals. Due to the nature of the coal, you will understand then this one the non-metals. Coal piece, pencil and lead, sulfur piece break into a smaller pieces and form powder when beaten with a hammer. When you will spread it, it will not spread, it will break down into the pieces and sometimes it will convert into the powder also. Conclusion: metals like aluminium, copper and iron are malleable. Malleable means it will spread into a thin sheets, whereas non-metals like coal, pencil, lead and sulfur are brittle. Brittle means it will not spread into the sheets, it will convert into the pieces. Now third physical property is ductility. The property which allows the metals to be drawn into thin wire is called ductility. When the metals after getting the heat, it will spread into the thin wire. It is a property of the metals ductility. Gold, silver are among the best ductile metals. It means it can spread into the wires more than other metals. Copper, aluminium, iron and magnesium metals can easily be drawn into thin wires, so they are very ductile. The wire inside the electric cables are mostly made up of copper metals. Means in your home, the wires, electric wires, inside of the electric wires used mostly the copper wires, copper metal. Non-metals are non-ductile. Because when we give the heat to the non-metals, means hammer to the non-metals, it will not spread into the sheets. It cannot be ductile also. It will be convert into the pieces. When stretched non-metals like sulfur and phosphorus breaks into pieces and do not form wires. Luster means shining nature. Mostly all the metals are in the shining nature. Most of the metals are lustrous, means shining, brightness. They have a shiny surface. This property is called metallic luster. The shiny surface of metals makes them good reflectors of light, because you know the quality characteristics of the light. When the light falls onto the any shiny object, it reflects from there, it come back from there. So shiny surface of the metals makes them good reflectors of light because of their metallic luster. Gold, silver and platinum metals are used for making jewelry and the decorative articles. Okay. Non-metals do not have shiny appearance like metals. Just like metals have a shiny nature, non-metals have not a shiny nature. They have dull appearance. However, iodine, some exceptions are there. Iodine is a non-metals and graphite also is a non-metals. It show a lustrous nature, means shiny nature. Conductivity of heat. Metals are good conductors of heat, whereas non-metals are poor conductors of heat. These lines you are continuity study from the your class, 5th class, 6th class, 7th class, and now you are in the 8th class also. Silver is the best conductor of heat, followed by copper. Means silver is the best conductor of heat, followed by copper. Aluminium and iron are also good conductors of heat. For this reason, metals like aluminium, iron and copper are used for making utensils and water boilers. when the utensil you are keeping on your gas stove, it need a heat, then after it cook to the food. So generally utensils are made with aluminium, iron, copper, these all are using in the utensils. However, bismuth is a poor conductor of heat. This is the metals, but it is not giving the characteristics of the conductivity of the heat nature of the metals, bismuth. Poor conductors of the heat. Non-metals are poor conductors of heat. Diamond is the only non-metals which is a good conductor of heat. Non-metals is, you know the nature of the metals and the non-metals. Metals, generally you are understood the metals are the good conductor of the heat and non-metals are the poor conductor of the heat. But here, diamond is a non-metals and it is a good conductor of the heat. Some exceptions are there. Carbon in our nature, carbon you are seeing, this is the form of the diamond. Hardness. Metals are generally hard. For example, iron metal is very hard and strong. So, iron metal is very hard and strong. Metals, nature of the metal is a very hard in nature. When you touch it, looking wise and touching, after touching you feel it is so hard in nature. So iron metal form used in the construction of bridge, railway lines, machine, these all are using in construction of the construction of bridges. Using, what is the using here? Metals are using. Sodium, potassium are soft metals. These two names are names of the metals, but this is quality wise it is soft in nature. Some one exceptions also in the metals hardness also. Can easily be cut with a knife. Which one? Sodium and potassium. When you, if you want, cut it just like you are cutting vegetables at your home, you can cut this sodium and potassium. It will cut with knife also. Then we cannot say all the metals are hard in nature. Some metals are soft in nature also, sodium and potassium. Non-metals, generally we understood there, non-metals are soft in nature, but non-metals are not hard or strong. They are easily break when a large weight is put on them, but only diamond is a hardest naturally occurring substance. Diamond is not soft, it is a naturally occurring substance, hardest substance. It means not hard, it is a hardest substance in the nature. If you are comparable to diamond from the gold, silver, these all, then you will get diamond is a hardest natural substance. Now tensile strength. The property which allow a substance to bear a lot of strain without breaking it called tensile strength. Tensile strength means when you keep something, when you keep something in the seat of the metals, then it will not, means that metal will be not break down. It can spread, it can tolerate to very hard and hard objects. So iron can bear a lot of strain without breaking. It is using in the bridge, it is using in the railway lines, machines. Generally, these all are making with help of the iron because it is a cheap also and it is available everywhere. Thus, it is used in construction of bridge. However, zinc has low tensile strength. Non-metals have low tensile strength, so they break easily. However, carbon fibers has high tensile strength. See here, students, multiple choice questions. The only metal known to occur in liquid form is mercury. Mercury is a metal. It comes occur in the nature is in liquid state, room temperature also. So mercury is the right answer. Which of the following metals is used for breaking foil to pack food stuff? You are using in your lunch box sometimes aluminium foil. It is here the answer, C option is the right answer, aluminium. The best malleable metal is gold, means the metal which is spread into the thin and thin to thin sheets, not copper, aluminium, zinc. Gold is the best malleable metal.
The only non-metal which is liquid at room temperature is non-metal means bromine. It occurs in room temperature liquid state. Which of the following metals is used for making jewelry? Both B and C. Platinum and silver. These all are making in jewelry. Now we are coming density. Metals have high densities, but sodium and potassium have low densities. These all are the metals. It means they have no heaviness. Densities means heaviness. Metals have high densities, but sodium and potassium have low densities. Non-metals have low densities and are very soft, but diamond has high densities. Conductivity of electricity. All the metals are good conductors of electricity. All the metals. Silver metal is the best conductor of electricity. Silver is the metal which one is the best conductor of electricity. Generally, we are using the copper metal in our home, but silver is the best metal which conduct to the electricity. Okay. Copper wires are used in household electric wiring and aluminium wires are used in electric cables because copper and aluminium are good conductors of electricity. Non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. For example, sulfur and phosphorus are non-metals and they do not conduct electricity. Graphite is a non-metal which is very good conductors of electricity. Each and every physical state we have seen one exceptions are there, one or two exceptions are there. Here is a also poor non-metals are poor conductors. We all understood this one. But graphite is a non-metal which is very good conductors of electricity. Okay, one activity is also again activity 2. To show that metals are good conductors of electricity and non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. For this you will take an electric cell, an electric bulb, a key, conducting wires, copper, aluminium and iron nail, coal and sulfur. In activity 2, you all are seeing in the page number 58. Methods. Make an electric tester by connecting a cell, an electric bulb, a key and connecting wires to test whether electricity can pass through an object or not. As at last you will understood in this activity ki where the metals are conduct passing through the electricity, the bulb is on and where the light is, means electricity is passing through the cell. Why the non-metals it will not conduct, it will not, bulb is not on. So these are the best activity to show the metals are the good conductors and non-metals are the poor conductors. Conclusion: metals like iron, copper and aluminium are good conductors of electricity. Non-metals are like coal and sulfur are poor conductors of electricity. Here you are seeing diagrams are 4.7a. in the first, metals are for A number. Metals are good conductors of electricity and B, non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. Why? Because in the B number diagrams, coal is attached to this wire through the bulb. And the A number diagram, iron nail is using to conduct the electricity. So A number diagram, bulb will on and B number diagram, bulb will not on because it attached with help of the non-metals. Okay, next point, your next characteristics of physical characteristics are sonority. Means when you hit to the metals, then it make a sonorous sound. It give a sonorous sound. This is the physical property of sonority metals. The property of producing a ringing sound by a metal when it strikes with a hard material in is called sonority. When you were in the class, then you were listening the bell hanging by the baiji, then it was sonorous sound. So again you will come back in the school and you will listen this one. The property of producing a ringing sound by a metals when it strikes with a hard material is called sonority. Thus metals are sonorous. For this reason metals are used for making bells. Metals wires are used in musical instruments.
Non-metals do not make a ringing sound when we strike them. Thus, non-metals are non-sonorous. Right now, you are sitting on the table, and if you will hit this one by anything, then it will not make a sonorous sound. It means it is a non-metals table. What tables? Tables leg part is a metals, but the part you are using for a study, it is a non-metals made by the wood. It will not give a sonorous sound. Melting and boiling points. Metals generally have Metals generally have high melting and boiling points. For example, iron metals has a melting point of 1535 degrees Celsius. Means iron metal can melt. You know, when you melt to the wax at your home for anything, any region, then you are getting, when you give the heat to the candle, then it give a flame and it is going to the melt, because it requires a less amount of heat. But iron is for melting, it require a high amount of heat, means 1535 degrees Celsius. However, sodium, potassium, mercury and the gallium have low melting points. Okay, these are the metals, but it require a low melting point. Non-metals have low melting point and boiling points. For example, the melting point of sulfur is 115 degrees Celsius. However, diamond has very high melting point. Okay, now in this chapter, you are seeing differences between physical properties of metals and non-metals. The physical properties means looking wise, appearing wise, you are seeing the metals and non-metals, and what is the difference between them. Here are all the mentions, name by physical state, malleability, luster, and conductivity of heat, hardness, electrical conductivity, sonority, tensile strength, melting and boiling point. These all are explained already today's class. So I'm going to over this class. I hope you will understood this physical properties of metals and non-metals. In next class, dear, you all understood, you will understand by me chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Okay, bye.